Hello guys, welcome back once again. This is Jagrat here, and in the previous session we have already seen the theoretical concept of inheritance, and we also saw the some types of inheritance. Okay, so in this session we will perform some implementation part, okay, regarding the inheritance. We will also cover the concept of method overriding. Okay, so let me remind you again, what is inheritance? See, this is a class A, okay, and this is class B. This class A is called parent class. I've already told you, I'm just reminding, this is class B called child class. Okay, and this is a relationship between A and B. Okay, so B can inherit the properties of class A. Okay, what actually this relationship is called, I will tell you at the time of implementation. Okay, so let me create a one class. So let us suppose my class name is A, okay, and I will not select this public static void main because I am designing this class. So just click on this finish. So I have already told you that in a particular class there are some variables and there are some methods. Okay, so we have to define the properties of this class. So let us suppose I am giving like this, int x is equal to 10. Okay, so this is class variable. Now let's define some method for this class. So public void, let us suppose we define a test method. Okay, and in this method I am just printing that class A, okay, test method like this. Let me copy this. Let me define some another variable. See, I've already told you duplicate methods are not allowed, so I am changing the name of this method. So class A test when method. And let me create one more method, test2. So class A test2 method. Okay guys, so in this class A I defined one class variable and three methods. Okay, so class A designing is completed. Now the another thing is class B. Okay, so let me create a class B. Okay, I am designing this class, so I will not select this public static void main. So this is our class B. Let me again define one variable, x is equal to, let us suppose, 20. Okay, and I am defining method, let us suppose test method, and in which I will print system.out.println class B test method. Okay, so this is the first method. The next method that we will design, like in test A we have already defined 1, 2. Okay, so here I will give test 3 like this. Okay, let us suppose we have two methods in class B. So guys, you can see here, so far there is no relation between class A and class B. Okay, But according to the concept of inheritance, we have to define a relationship. Okay. That class B is a child class of class A. So how can we define that relationship? With the help of extends keyword. Okay, so we will write like public class B extends A. So with the help of this, it means B is extending the properties of class A. And in the diagrammatic representation, I have already told you this thing. This class B can inherit the properties of class A. So with the help of extends keyword, we can define the relationship between parent class and subclass. Okay. So just understand the concepts step by step. Okay. And guys, this relationship is also called has a relationship. This is also called has a relationship. When any particular class extends another class, then this relationship is called has a relationship. Okay. So with the help of this, we can define, we can code our inheritance concept. Okay. So as you can see here, I defined a particular class A in which we defined a variable, then some methods. In class B also we defined some variables and methods, and with the help of extends keyword, I defined like this that class B extends class A. Means class B is a subclass of class A. So now there is a proper relationship between class B and class A. Okay. Now look at this code. Guys, in class A we defined test method. Okay, so you can see here there is a test method that is defined, and in class B also we defined the same test method. Okay, so guys, this concept is called method overriding. Okay, so let me define here method overriding. So what is method overriding? Same method name with same arguments are defined in different class. Okay, so this concept is called method overriding. You know, same method name. The method name is test. Here also the method name is test. Here zero number of argument. In class B also zero number of arguments. So with same arguments are defined in different class. So this test method is defined in class B and this test method is defined in class A. So this concept is called overriding. If the same method name with same arguments are defined in different class, then this concept is called method overriding. And guys, this method is called overridden method. This method is called overridden method. Okay. In a class A, we defined a test method. Again in class B we define test method, that's why this test method is called overridden method. Okay, so far we did not incorporate any main method. So now it's time to define a test class in which we will incorporate the main method. So test inheritance. and we will click on this main method. Okay. So now we will create the object of this, you know, child class. So let's create the object. So B, let us suppose object name, object reference variable is obj is equal to new B, like this. Okay. I told you many times the interpretation of this line. Okay, so I will not repeat again and again. Now let me access the methods first. Okay, so firstly I will access these methods. Okay, so can I access test method? Yes, we can access test method like this. Okay, can I access test 3 method? Yes, we can access test 3 method. See, it will give you automatically suggestion. Okay, so guys, can I access test 1 method? Yes, I have already told you that this B can also access the properties of this class A. Okay, so just understand the concept. So obj dot test 1 we can access. Can we access test 2? Yes, we can access test 2 like this. So with the help of this object, B class object, or we can say child class object, we can access its child methods as well as its superclass methods. Okay. So another important thing, let me run this program and let me see the output. So you can see here guys, the first it will call test method. So here a new concept generates. Guys, please see very careful that this test method is present in B class also, and this test method is present A class also. So which test method will be called? So always remember, overridden method will be called. Okay, overridden method will be called. Overridden method will always be called. Let's run this again. So you can see here, when we will call this test method, then what it will give the output? Class B test method. It will give, it will call this method, not class A method. Okay, so if the same method name is present in super class as well as the child class, then overridden method will be called. Just note down this point. Then it will call test 3 method. So test 3 method is present only in class B, so it will call class B test 3 method. You can see the second output. Okay, then it will call test 1 method. So test 1 method is present in only class A, and you know guys, class B is a child class of class A, so it can inherit the properties. So that's why test 1 method is called, and it will print like that, class A test 1 method. Same case for test 2. Okay. So here I am writing for you guys, here overridden method will be called. This is the most important point here. Okay, and guys, this concept is called static polymorphism, or we can say compile time polymorphism. Okay, compile time polymorphism, because at the time of compilation, Java compiler will decide which method I have to call. Okay guys, same case we can also create the object of parent class also. Okay, so let me create an object of parent class also. Same method, new A, like this. Okay, so let's access the methods. Okay, can we access test method? Yes, we can access test method. So it will give you automatically suggestion like this. Okay, obj1 dot, can we access test1 method? Yes, we can access test1 method. It will give you the suggestion like this. Okay, can we access test2 method? Yes, we can access test2 method. Okay, because it is present in class A. Guys, can we access test3 method? No, we cannot access test3 method. You can see here, if we will write test3 like this, okay, so you can see here it will give you a error. See, this is not possible. Why this is not possible? I have already told you. You can see this diagram. Test3 method is defined in class B, and parent class A cannot take the properties of subclass B. Okay, B can inherit all the properties of A, but A cannot take any property of B. Okay guys, so let's run this program. Let me differentiate so you can easily understand. Okay, so let me run this program and we can see the output. See, a ob1 dot new a, so ob1 dot test. Okay, so this is the object reference variable for class A. Okay, so class A is, you know, this test method, class A test method. That's why it is printed in console. Okay, why it is not printing class B test method? Because A cannot access the methods of B. So there is only one option for Java compiler to call this test method. That's why it is printing class A test method. Okay, then obj1 test1 method, of course test1 method is present in class A, so it will call class A test1 method, and same case for class A test2 method also. Okay guys, so far we designed a class, parent class, we designed a, you know, subclass, we created a relationship between parent class as well as the subclass, and then we define a test class to call all these methods of subclass as well as the parent class. We also saw the concept of method overriding. We also saw the concept of static polymorphism, or we can say compile time polymorphism. Okay, so that's all for this session. So in the next session, I will tell you some basic experiments. Okay, so far we told you the concept of static polymorphism, but what about the runtime polymorphism or dynamic polymorphism? Okay, so we will see the concept of dynamic polymorphism in the next session. We will also see the concept of super keyword. This is the very important keyword that is most widely used in inheritance. Okay, so we will also see that how can we achieve, how can we implement the concept of super keyword. So see you in the next session. Bye bye.